So, children, we will continue today's class with the last question from exercise 4B, and it will be question number 10. See, we have done lots of questions, and now this is the last question, and it is question number 14. Question number 14 it is, and this is very wrong. Calculating of a single discount. That means if there are two successive discounts given in a question, and how to calculate one discount that will be equal to the two successive discount. So we are getting a different direct formula for that. Okay. So find a single discount equivalent to two successive discounts of 20% and 10%. So here see, we have to assume that that single discount should be D percent. Okay. So right here, let the single discount is equal to D percent. Okay. Now this single discount is D percent. This D percent is equal to what? The success discount of two discounts. So we'll assume that this D percent discount is a single discount. So this single discount is equal to two successive discounts. These discounts which are successive will be given in the question. What are the successive discounts? 20% and 10%. So right here. How much they are given? Question is given as 20% and 10%. Now see, there is one formula that will correlate them, and see how we use the formula SP. Now see, after the discount, what you are getting? After applying the discount, you are getting the selling price. That means we equate the single discount equal to the SP and successive discount equal to the SP. How? See, SP is nothing like, SP is D percent discount. Now see, in this case mark price is fixed, so it will be 1 minus D by 100 into NP. And SP is twenty percent discount. And see, discount always brings a decrease in price. That's why don't ever think that you will write plus sign there. So always one minus will be there. Okay. I hope you get this thing. How much it will be? 1 minus 20 upon 100 into 1 minus 10 upon 100 multiplied by mark price. So the mark price has to remain the same. Now children, tell me one thing. Don't you think both these things will be equal? They have to be, because the D is one single discount. That will be equivalent to these two discounts. That means, suppose I give you, someone gives you 20 rupees in at a time, and suppose another person gives you 10 rupees and 10 rupees in two times. Can we say total money given by that person is 20 rupees, both of them? Yes, only a different way of giving. First person gave you 20 rupees at a time instantly, but the second person has given you in two installments. So like that. So that therefore, 1 minus D by 100 into MP will equal to 1 minus 20 by 100 into 1 minus
10 by 100 into MV.
Now amperes will be cancelled, we don't worry about this. This is like that. Let me see whether this much is visible to you or not. I think so, if I go further below, it will not be visible in the board also. So I'll rub the remaining portion at the top. That's why I have to check it out always. So the upper lines I'm rubbing. So let me write this thing what I did. So it's 1 minus V by 100 into MV. So MV will be cancelled on both sides. Moving ahead, it will be 1 minus V by 100 is equal to 1 minus 20 is what? 20 by 100 is 1 by 5. 1 minus 1 by 5 is 4 by 5. Multiplied by 10 by 100 is 1 by 10. 1 minus 1 by 10 is 9 by 10. Right? 9 by 10. Now your question reduces to a simple question and problem will be simple only. Now it is 9 for the 36, 36 for 25. So we will write here 1 minus 36 for 25. 20 V by 100. Then what? So it should be yes, I think so. This should be 9 by 10, not 9 by 5. Yes, it will be 9 by 10 here. So it is 9 by 10. 36 by 50. Yes. 36 by 50. That's all right. So 1 minus 1 by 10 is 9 by 10. So this will be what? It is transposition only here. Now this is like that. This should be the answer. Let us verify it. Yes, that is the answer. Moving on to exercise 4C. Exercise 4C. Let us see some questions here. Now these are based on the taxes and all. About which I have told you always. Like you have seen different taxes, if at all you agree to some restaurant or you are purchasing some commodities, there you are giving some extra money, CGST, SGST, wherever you are getting a printed bill, you will find that state GST, central GST, value added tax, service tax, all these things are there. You purchase some commodity, in the detailed invoice, you will find that the original price of the item is less. And some GST is added there, all these things are there. So we find that how it is affecting our day-to-day lives and adding to the expenditure of ours. So let us see some more questions on 4C, which will further continue. Now see, gold ring with marked price is much and tax is 12%. So first question, first part I am solving for you your gold. Remaining all the parts are easy, it is not too much difficult for you. Only see, tax you have to reduce from the marked price. So these all taxes are just
kind of subtraction only. The important thing is, no, taxes are not subtracted, taxes will be added. So whatever price is marked on that, you have to add to the tax there. So if you are purchasing some dress, like some wardrobe you are purchasing, or the pullovers or blazers like that, so there they are giving you discount. Suppose now, see, it is January time, so soon 26 January will come. So that time Republic Day sale is coming. Okay, you find them different outlets of clothes like Reliance Trends and other things are there. They will offer some discount. So whatever price is marked on that, discount is the marked price, and that discount is subtracted. Whereas the tax that is imposed will be added. Like taxes on the something that we always experience is the fuel prices. Okay, so there is tax on that. Okay, then if you are probably purchasing some subscriptions of like Amazon Prime, Netflix, Z5, whatever, so you'll find that base price is less, but tax added is also taken away from your pocket only. Means whatever tax is being imposed by the government, that also you only are paying. So mark price is given here, tax is given, 12% tax is given. So right here, but they have asked final price. So right here, final price. What is total going to do? It is 13,000 plus 12% tax is 12% of 13,000. This was coming in the question. I think this one here, 2 zeros cancel, 2 zeros cancel. Then 1 0 will come here. 12 36 6 3 carry 12 12 15. 1 5 6 0 plus 13. So 5 6 will come here only. Then 13 and 14. So rupees 14,560. That will be the cost. Nothing difficult. You can just compare these questions to questions where they are giving you that. 12% is added to a number, or a number is increased by 12% of the number. Find the final number. If you have done questions based on linear equations, you will find them easy and handy to do. Okay. Let me take up one more question from question number 2. Do you try on your own? No. Separate questions are there. So question number 2, I am doing the fourth part. Question number 2, first part I'm doing for you on the board. Very soon we'll be starting with simple and compound interest. Simple interest is the same thing that you're done in class 7. And compound interest is due for you. I'll request that you study the chapter also, the theory portion. And also I'll be covering the theory portion in the video lectures also. I'm taking another question. That is the second question, fourth part. That says 5% tax is included in the price. This thing you must have seen when you go to some restaurant. They are writing the prices, and you feel like the prices are too much. But the actual thing is, the price they have written after adding GST. Because sometimes it becomes like marketing or selling strategy, that write the price lesser. That see, we are charging less. It is the government tax that is imposed on us. It is not none of our problems. Okay. Sometimes as a selling strategy, the companies or vendors are saying, see, 236 rupees only. This is what goes into my pocket. The 12% or 18% GST is taken up by the government of India. I am not taking it. So he writes a price in a deceitful way. So that time, sometimes people tend to quarrel that you are telling the price is this much only, and now you are telling me GST also. So it becomes sometimes very difficult. So here also the question: the price of calculator they have written inclusive of the tax. So what is the price? Price inclusive of tax is. ₹508.20. Now see, this price has come how? This price has come after adding 5% tax. Now this 5% tax is over the this 5% tax is over the market price. And what have they asked? They have asked price before tax. Let market price for 2 rupees X. Price after 5% tax. X by 20 is how much? 21x by 20. And according to question, what will happen? Is this question visible to you or not? According to the question, what we can write? We can write as writing it above. That is all about the exercise. So we have to just assume a price and then add the further things, like what is should be the original price, and after adding the tax, so we have the original, the price is what they have given. The question is inclusive of the tax, so the price you have to reduce. So you have to take some base price and add 5% to it and equate it to the increased price.